Politics can be an interesting game, and often it's not as squeaky clean as people want you to think. Often it can be a game full of secrets, and when anyone appears to have clean hands, it may just be a smokescreen. The dirty work of politics brings us to today's video, the Red Dead Redemption Stranger Side Mission, American Lobbyist. First, we'll be talking about the Stranger Side mission itself, and then we'll get onto all the extra details that make it a little bit more interesting, as even for Stranger missions, it's quite a short story. To begin it, we need to head to this spot in Blackwater. It's not too difficult to find, it's at the center of a square on the northern side of the town. Here on the gazebo, we'll meet a rather suspicious-looking, well-dressed man.
Hello there, sir. You look like a man who can do an honest day's work for an honest day's pay.
Then looks can be deceiving, pal.
Perfect. As honesty is, in my business, the worst policy. I work for our well-respected governor, Nate Johns.
That makes sense.
Now, there is a certain individual spreading nasty rumors about Mr. Johns. I'd like you to put a stop to this vile gossip and malingering.
Suppose I can handle that? For the right price?
Now, this individual has had the misfortune to be photographed enjoying some rather inappropriate company. Been seen with a local whore. Take these photographs to him. After you take care of business, return to me and I'll pay up the reward for your services. You're doing great things for your state, dear friend. You should be proud.
So now I've got to go and take some blackmail photographs to blackmail a guy in the name of Nate Johns, who's running for governor of the state. He's just in the building on the western side of the square on the north side of Blackwater, but you need to come here in business hours as you cannot gain access to what I presume is a bank at night. So let's take a look at these blackmail photos in the meantime. Christ. But now it's time to return to the bank at day and have words with this fine gentleman.
Hey there, fella. What do you think of our governor, Nate Johns?
Nate Johns? Why, that no good lying, backstabbing bastard, I'd like to see him horsewhipped. Why you ask, friend?
Need to make sure I had the right man. Would you care to take a quick look at a couple photographs of you coming out of a fine place of not much repute?
What?
As I was saying, before I was so rudely interrupted, Nate Johns is a fine, fine man and an even better governor. And I consider it an honor to call him my friend.
Wise man.
Coercion complete, it's time to head back to the gazebo and get our reward. It's not much of a cutscene really, the man just dashes us some money, that's really it. Interestingly, in any playthrough, this is not the first time we hear about Nate Johns. The first time is a conversation held right at the beginning of the game between two elderly ladies sat behind John on a train.
Apparently, Mr. Johns wants to run for governor, which is why he's so concerned with cleaning up the state.
Nate Johns.
Yes.
His family is nothing but hillbilly trash that came here after the war. I don't want to be judgmental, but this state should not be ruled by such a disgusting family. A family without class.
Apparently, the Johns family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy voters, though.
So it seems as if Nate John's underhanded tactics are at least somewhat suspected. In fact, NPCs around the United States areas of the game can be heard mentioning that John's is more crooked than a dog's hind leg. So his corruption is hardly a secret, but he has political allies, and furthermore, he has money, which worst comes to worst, he can use to buy a substantial portion of the voters. And as we've seen in the Stranger mission, he's also capable of stooping to blackmail and extortion to secure his position. We can also read about Mr. Johns in a couple of newspaper articles. These two articles read as follows. Johns leading race. Atkinson disgraced in race crime. Mr. Nate Johns looks likely to be our next governor, following remarkable revelations about the private business affairs of his rival, Archibald Atkinson. Mr. Atkinson, a recent transplant from Alabama, was found to have flaunted important government regulations in several businesses his family owns and maintains, alongside tax evasion and countless unpaid invoices. What is particularly shocking is the revelation that Mr. Atkinson failed to enforce racial segregation adequately and actually allowed non-whites to sit in the same room as Europeans. At various times, documented reports show serious code violations in which blacks, natives, Mexicans, and other unspecified colored people were allowed to eat, drink, pray, receive medical care, and educational teaching in establishments run, owned, or managed by the Atkinson family, including a church at which his brother preaches. This shocking behavior simply cannot be tolerated in a new, still-forming society such as ours here in the West, and the voters have responded with the appropriate outrage and disgust. When pushed for a comment, Mr. Atkinson's office responded, "Archibald Atkinson bitterly refuses these claims. Like all good Americans, he is a passionate racial supremacist and implicitly understands that the natural order of things should be maintained. He would, however, prefer to focus the campaign on things that matter for the region, issues like crime, healthcare provision, and urban expansion are very important to the campaign, much more so than some silly slurs about racial integration." The other article reads, "Nate Johns promises change as governor." With the gubernatorial elections looming, Nate Johns delivered a series of bold and impressive speeches this week, in which he promised to halve crime and taxes by 1915. Sounds too good to be true. And vowed that every household in the state would have an automobile, an indoor toilet, and one literate family member by 1920. Campaigning under the slogan, "Make the West Fair Again." Crikey. Mr. Johns has been dogged by accusations of corruption and claims that he is out of touch with the common man. Despite his family's immense wealth and influence, Mr. Johns maintains that he is a man of humble origins with people's best interests at heart. Were that true, I can't imagine he would have allowed one of his employees to outsource blackmail work to us. But it appears quite obvious that Nate Johns' tactics in politics are use money to gain influence, coerce people where necessary, use underhand tactics to bump off the competition, and make material promises to win over the remainder of the voters. However, in the 1914 final issue of the Blackwater Ledger available in the game, we discovered that he does finally get found out for his corruption in an article that reads as follows. "Governor Johns indicted. State Governor Nate Johns has been indicted on a plethora of criminal charges, including corruption, extortion, and moral indecency. He is linked to the disappearance of a series of politicians and labor unionists, and under investigation for the forceful acquisition of farmlands on behalf of businesses in which his family holds a majority stake. He was also accused of sexually assaulting 7 female staff members and battery of a prostitute, but these charges were dropped after officials deemed all the acts to be consensual. Even his election itself 3 years ago is shrouded in controversy, after a large number of ballots were discovered showing the names of Indians, who are of course not permitted to vote under any circumstances. Mr. Johns is reported to be taking an extended vacation in Canada." So he does get elected governor in 1911, however it all comes crashing down as his dirty laundry gets aired rather publicly, and instead of facing it like a man of honour, he fucks off to Canada. And despite all of this information, we never actually meet the guy, though his influence is felt as his clean up the state policy may be the reason why the Bureau of Investigation is so prominent in the state. The Bureau being, of course, the reason why John Marston is at the mercy of the government. I always find it fascinating how much detail Rockstar puts into even the smallest of encounters in their game. Nate Johns isn't relevant to the story at all, however, there's plenty of references to him, and the Stranger mission revolving around him is only so long, and in the most subtle way possible, there's so much information to take in for what it is that it's unreal. And that's what I really love about the Red Dead games. But of course, that brings us to the end of this video. Thank you all for watching, I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to go ahead and leave a like, subscribe, share the channel with your friends and all that wonderful stuff, that would be super fantastic. And with any luck, I'll be seeing you all very soon with another video at some point, but until next time, take care and goodbye.